people just said that this is the marketing team, but they're doing sales promotion.
So, a resource is hired by HR.
Yeah.
Who gives a KRA of that person? The marketing head. The marketing head himself doesn't know the difference between a content writer and a copywriter. He thinks he writes both. So the marketing head also doesn't know you need a social community manager. That guy is not supposed to do content marketing. Presently, I'm consulting an infrastructure company. The MD is telling me, I want a copywriter who's an engineer, because he will understand my architecture and the specification. I said, no. A content writer's job is to be a creative person. Find someone who understands content, who can write well. So the definition of KRA is also not known. So it's like a blind man is helping another blind man to cross the road. That's what is happening.
So one of the points, if you notice on page 3, we have very clearly mentioned the difference between what an agency is and what a consultancy is.
Yeah.
And that you would rather be a consultant than be working on an agency profile work atmosphere.
Yeah, consulting, most SME don't hire a consulting. They hire generally expert who is a domain expert, and mostly people or the company also don't know their problem solve cannot be done by an agency, should be done by a domain expert, right? So it's like specialization of knowledge. For a heart surgery, will you go to a general physician?
No.
Why?
He's not a specialist.
He can't operate.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So for a very deep dive knowledge level, you go to a surgeon.
Mm-hmm.
So consulting job is more of a knowledge driven. It is very holistic. Consulting doesn't see a problem by Facebook or a Twitter ad or a LinkedIn ad or a like or a follower. Don't do like that. So that's the big, that's
right.
What I mentioned.
So again, some quotes, okay?
To start a company, you need a capital.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't have a capital.
Mm.
So when I didn't have a capital, when I didn't have money to start a company, I asked myself, what is it that I have?
Mm.
And I can I trade that?
Mm.
So I figure out I have knowledge. I can trade knowledge to get people work for me.
Mm.
It's a very unique model. I don't think many company will be able to do that, because today's kids or today's people, you cannot fake them for a long time. So I challenge all the students who want to work with me. I said, you can work with me for 6 months and I will not pay you.
Mm.
In fact, she is the one who is doing internship. I'm not paying her.
Mm.
She came all the way from Kolkata. But every day I teach her and I learn. When I teach and I make them learn, so such people you can only get when people come for, when they see knowledge as a motivation or money as a motivation. So when you have a pocket money driven attitude, you will never come to me, and I don't want that. So what I did, since I didn't have a capital, I needed people to work with me. So I traded my knowledge so that people came to me, I taught them, make them also work with me for 6 months. One, many people right now, I have 20 people whom I've hired after 6 months. So that's the reason I traded. So without capital, you can still run a company, so you can still build a company. So if you really want to do, you will find some way or the other. I didn't have money or office or nothing. I started everything from my home. 3 months it happened. Then I booked a small table and a chair in AWFIS, which is a office space where I was consulting. And that's how it started.
So till to date, how many students have worked with you?
I have 20 people, all of them are my students.
So at this point, they are, you could say, internship kind of a...
No, after 6 months internship expired, you get into a consulting role. So junior consultant, senior consultant, like that. So most of the
these
people...
These students are from your lectures only, the ones...
Yeah. Okay, one more thing I must tell you. I don't have a CV of a single people who work with me. Because I never interviewed them.
Okay.
I don't have a single CV of my people. Because I never interviewed them. Same thing. All the clients who work with me, I never pitched. So if you go to my website, in a very bold manner, if you try to contact me, it says 97% of the chance I'll say no to you. So I don't look for client, neither look for people. Everything is inbound. I could only do that because I understand digital marketing in the manner where you can spread your content in such a manner, people get attracted to it and they will come to you.
That is some clarity that we wanted. One is you clearly stated that you have not interviewed any student. So what are the basic benchmark that you would look for in a student?
Okay, I work in a very different and weird manner. I don't look for certificate, I don't look for percentage, I don't ask where you are. I only look for attitude. I hire attitude. I don't hire skill. Which means, this girl, when he came and approached me, she said, I wanted to get into content marketing video, but I don't know anything. I said, fantastic, I'll teach you. Because in your CV or in interview, can you find out the attitudinal percentage? He's a good man or a bad boy or attitude issue, has an ego, he can't. What will I do with a 98 score and with a bad profile? So I always hire attitude. I never hire skill.
And you also clearly stated that you don't pitch. So if you could be more descriptive on that.
Okay. I always get found. Okay, hold on. Right now we are all talking.
Yeah.
Where the germination happened? Because I never came to your college. Neither I got in touch with Reshmi. I never knew her, right?
Mm-hmm.
How it happened? I was talking in BSc. And few of your students were standing and hearing that.
Mm.
So they didn't know Subhobroto is. They heard my content.
Mm.
So that is the first germination which happened. They went and told Reshmi, why don't you call this person to our college? I came and gave lecture. Then I started knowing Reshmi. Then she again asked me to come a few times. So if you see, the starting point is not Subhobroto or my profile or my CV or my LinkedIn. My starting point is my content. Content works like a magic. So the moment you have great content, people will find you. Do a good doctor use a phone and go around the street looking for patient? No. So you actually wait for a good doctor, travel 2-3 kilometers or maybe other city, wait outside, wait months and wait outside, and you don't get frustrated. And then you pay him more because you know this doctor will be curing you.
Did any literature influence you in this sort of thinking?
Yeah. There's one book which changed my life. That's called Inbound Marketing by HubSpot Dharmeshit. That book, because I'm very shy of looking for business. I don't ask. It's very uncomfortable. I'm not a businessman. So it makes me very uncomfortable. So when I started my consulting, I was thinking, why will I get business? Because I can't tell my friends and colleagues, can I come and pitch? So this content marketing helped me to get attracted. Every day, today also, every day I get new business. I reject 97%.